Who are the British? The question seems simple, but the answer is written in a secret history within the DNA of the descendants of those who have inhabited these islands for thousands of years. Roman rule, Viking conquests, Anglo-Saxon migrations, to even more modern-day invasions. It's inarguable that we have a great amount of diversity on these isles, and today we go through history to explore the genetic diversity of modern Britons. Disclaimer, by Briton I do mean one whose ancestry is linked to the UK for at least the last millennia. I am mainly focusing on research conducted to understand the genetics of the UK from 12,000 years ago to 1,000 years ago. It's a story of epic migrations, of vanishing people and genetic ghosts. And for a long time, we could only guess the truth. But today, we are armed with the power of modern genetics. We can finally understand that the secret history and what it reveals is not what you might have expected. Our story begins at the dawn of the modern Britain. The great ice sheets retreat, and the first continuous wave of hunter-gatherers settled here around 12,000 years ago. These are by no means the first humans or even the first hominins on the British Isles, but this is the beginning of a wave of humans which people alive today could possibly call their ancestors. For millennia, the first inhabitants were likely the only people on these isles. Then, around 6,000 years ago, farmers from mainland Europe, bringing a completely new way of life, forever changed this landscape. The genetic clock keeps ticking and the pace quickens. Around 2000 years ago, the Romans arrived and imposed their rule on most of modern-day Britain for nearly four centuries. And when they left a power vacuum. And around 1500 years ago, the Anglo-Saxons arrived, not as raiders, but as settlers who redefined the land. Then just 1200 years ago, a new terror from the seas arrived, the Vikings. For 300 years, Viking raids, trades, and settlements wrote another bloody chapter into Britain's DNA. And finally, just under 1,000 years ago, the Norman conquests occurred, a new French-speaking elite that changed Britain forever. Each of these groups left its mark in language, in culture, and most importantly for our story, in the DNA of Britons. For centuries, this DNA has been locked away, but in the early 20th century, scientists started the process of genotyping Britons using blood and good old eugenics. Blood types. Today we take them for granted, but their discovery was a revolution. At the dawn of the 20th century, this wasn't just academic curiosity. During the First World War, knowing a soldier's blood type allowed for more successful blood transfusions. The science was groundbreaking. For the first time, we understood our bodies had built-in markers. Type A blood has proteins that triggered an immune reaction from type B blood, and vice versa. Type O blood was known as a universal donor because it lacked these triggers. It was the first real testable, heritable human trait, and at the time only ABO blood groups were known. And this powerful medical device inspired years of eugenic research into different human races. Well, why not? With a ready supply of British and Indian soldiers, scientists led by Karl Leinsteiner noticed a pattern. The British had a higher frequency of type A blood, the Indians had a higher frequency of type B blood. This led to a bold theory that there were essentially two primary races of people, an A race from the north and a B race from the east, with everyone else being a mixture of these two races. It was one of the very first documented studies of human polymorphism, but it walked hand in hand with the ideas of eugenics popular at the time. This is the very definition of trying to read an entire library by looking through the keyhole. And the limitations of this keyhole view became very clear right on Britain's doorstep, in a place that would be known as Little England beyond Wales. In 1956, a study used the ABO blood group system to characterize over 1,600 individuals from Wales and Western England. A surprising discovery was made in one of the isolated corners of the southwestern region known as Pembrokeshire. An anonymously high frequency of blood group A individuals? This discovery would coin the region Little England beyond Wales. Was this a genetic echo of 9th century Viking settlements? Or Flemish farmers who were settled here in the 12th century? or a bit of both? With only one biomarker, it's hard to say. The ABO system set the groundwork for more modern genetic polymorphism studies. But nonetheless, it was an interesting part of genetic history and shed some light into the genetics of Britain. And in the 21st century, instead of one genetic marker, we could now analyze hundreds of thousands, and the use of computation improved our accuracy and capabilities. This was not looking through the keyhole anymore. We could see the whole library. A landmark 2015 study did exactly this. They analyzed over 500,000 DNA markers in over 2,000 people across the British Isles. With this, we can assess a deep and subtle pattern of the British history, and this can be viewed in the best way possible on a map. And what did this genetic time machine reveal? There were 17 different groups of Britons within four regional classes: Wales, Northern England, Scotland and Northern Ireland, Central England and Southern England, and Orkney. Firstly, the most genetically distinct group in the entire study were the people of the Orkney Islands. This is not surprising. For 600 years, Orkney was a Norse earldom, a critical hub of the Viking world. The relative isolation of the Orkney Islands and the historical Scandinavian influence have left a unique genetic signature, setting them apart from the rest of the British Isles, and is a clear echo to the Viking influence and admixture to Britain. Secondly, one of the biggest surprises came from when this genetic study revealed the legacy of the Anglo-Saxons. Based on historical evidence and this genetic data, we see that the Anglo-Saxon migrations around 1500 years ago were a transformative event, creating a new dominant genetic population that forms the backbone of modern England. A single, surprisingly homogeneous group that stretches from Yorkshire to the southern coast. But what about the people who were there before the Anglo-Saxons? Did they just vanish? Well, we find traces of pre-Anglo-Saxon and pre-Roman groups in Wales and the southwestern coast of England. When we move to the far southwest, another distinct group emerges: the Cornish. For millennia, Cornwall has maintained a separate cultural and linguistic identity from the rest of England. And now genetics proves it. Their DNA shows that they may have been largely untouched by waves of migration that swept through their neighbours. We can speculate that the unique groups in Cornwall have a relatively lower penetration of Anglo-Saxon or Viking admixture. However, the phylogenetic tree shows the population of Cornwall are more related to the rest of southern and central England than the most distant group in mainland Britain, the Welsh. Lastly, we can assess Wales, parts of which are likely the most genetically similar to populations that existed in pre-Roman Britain. We first spot some interesting details in Little England beyond Wales. Two groups exist here in this small geographic area of Pembrokeshire. Recall that study from the 50s we spoke about earlier that found that this area of Wales had a higher than expected frequency of Group A people. Could one of these groups be the descendants of the Viking settlers in the 9th century, and the other group be the descendants of the Flemish farmers who were settled here in the 12th century by Henry I? Unfortunately, we cannot answer these questions at this point. We also see a highly distinct group from the northern part of Wales. This population here might represent the most similar genetic people to pre-Anglo-Saxon and possibly even pre-Roman Britain. The mountains of Wales could have acted as a natural fortress, preserving the genetic heritage of the people who lived across these islands for thousands of years. The genetic distinctiveness of the Welsh and the Cornish people does not come from a Celtic gene. Instead, their DNA represents the clearest surviving genetic link to the ancient Celtic-speaking Britons who populated these islands before the Romans or Anglo-Saxons arrived. Well, that story isn't just about one group replacing another. It's a story of a beautiful, complex genetic mosaic created over thousands of years. This journey was made possible by the incredible work of scientists like Sir Walter Bodmer, whose 2015 paper formed the backbone of this video essay. You can find a citation down below. If you enjoyed, please like and consider subscribing. It really helps a lot. Thanks for watching, and see you next time for more science.